Hi everyone and welcome. In this review note, we are going to create another vSwitch or virtual switch. In this case, we're going to make things a little bit more complicated. We'll add two virtual machine port groups with different VLANs. We'll also have multiple uplinks so that we can team those network adapters together. As before, I'm going to start with add networking. I'm going to specify that I want a virtual machine port group for a standard switch. I'm going to create a new vSwitch. And I'll add two network adapters. So the first one will be VMNIC2. And then I will also add VMNIC3. In this case, these are set to active-active, which means that they will load balance. If I wanted to do active-passive, then I would demote one of these down to be a standby, but that's not what I want to do. Click on Next. Need to give this a name. I'm going to call this one Test, and I'm going to assign a VLAN ID of 2000. Click on Next and Finish. My new vSwitch will show up at the bottom of the list. I'll reveal that. And we can see that I've got my test port group, VLAN ID is 2000, and I have two network adapters. Next thing I'm going to do is add in another port group, add networking, again specify that I want a virtual machine port group. In this case, I'm not going to create a new virtual switch. I'm going to use vSwitch2, which is the one that was just created. Click on Next. Need to give this a name. I'm going to call it QA, and I'm going to make this VLAN 2100. Click on Next and Finish. We can see our additional port group. Because of the fact that QA and Test have two different VLAN IDs, VMs that are connected to these different port groups will not be able to communicate with each other. Since just like on a real switch, the vSwitch will isolate that traffic. One other thing I want to do is configure NIC teaming. I'm going to edit. And one of the options I have is teaming and failover. Right now, this is route based on originating virtual port. I'm going to change this to route based on IP hash, which is what we typically use today for NIC teaming. I'm going to leave the failure detection as link status only so it doesn't beacon. I will notify the switches in case of failure, and because of the fact that our adapters are active-active, failback doesn't really do anything. Click on OK for that. NIC teaming is now configured. We will have IP hashing as the algorithm that will be used to determine the routing over the different network adapters. Assuming that I've also configured on the physical switch to use IP hashing, then we will form a NIC team, or aggregate the ports if you wish, with the physical switch, and we will load balance between the two physical adapters. That's all there is to setting up a vSwitch with multiple port groups and teaming the NICs. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.